rare find has washed ashore near San Diego, a Pacific football fish. Joining us now with more on the deep sea creature is the collection manager of marine vertebrates for Scripps Institution of Oceanography, UCSD, Ben Frabel. Good morning, Ben.
Good morning.
So tell me, Ben, just first of all, I've seen you quoted as saying this is a dream come true. As somebody who studies fish, to have this fish in the condition that it was found in, where you're getting the opportunity to check it out, I mean, that's going to be amazing.
Oh, yeah, certainly. It's, you know, I feel like I found out about anglerfish when I was a young child, either in a book or a, you know, educational video game. And I've seen a few, but I've never seen a large specimen in that good of a condition.
Yeah, and so tell me a little bit, because it was found at Swami's Beach in Encinitas, and tell me a little bit about this specimen itself specifically.
So this was found on the beach last Friday morning, and luckily made it to the collection here at Scripps. So this specimen's about 15 and a half inches long. It's fairly large. It's one of the larger individuals of the species and one of the largest species of anglerfish in general. And its kind of most distinguishing characteristic is that little lure that it has on top of its head there. Folks may be familiar with that from Finding Nemo. There, you know, like there's a famous scene in there.
Right?
But at the tip of that lure, they have a little bulb of glowing bacteria, bioluminescent bacteria, that glows, and it attracts prey to them in the deep ocean.
So Paul Rudy wanted to know how many teeth it has, because it does not look very friendly.
yeah, certainly. Probably... Oh, at least over 100. I haven't counted.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so tell me how the process... Well, first of all, it's extremely rare, right? There's only, I think I saw 33 of these that have been placed in archives, right?
Actually, 31. This 31. Is the 31st, yeah.
Okay, and so obviously it's a pretty rare specimen, right? Especially being that it's the Pacific kind.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, and so tell me a little bit about what happens now. What are you going to do with it?
So here at the Scripps Marine Vertebrate Collection, we house an archive of preserved fish specimens that have been collected by folks all over the world over the last, generally last 70 years, but going back to the 1880s. And these are preserved and stored and examined by scientists, students, educators, artists, people all over the world. You can think about it like a library. So I am currently preserving this anglerfish to add to the collection so people can use it to study and ask questions to learn more about the biology of that fish or anglerfish in general. And it's going to be housed here for the foreseeable future, hopefully for decades or centuries to come.
Wow. And so this is very interesting as well, because there was another one that was photographed back in November. Then there was the lancet fish that washed up along shore, and now this one. So it seems like we're seeing quite a few of these deep sea fish that are washing up right here on our shores.
Yeah, it's definitely been a very exciting month for that kind of stuff. But, you know, as we've talked about, they're fairly rare, right? This is the 31st time, at least scientifically, we've ever seen that seen one. So we can't really, you know, say something is going on here. Honestly, could just be coincidence, could have something to do with their biology this time of year, or all the storms we've been having recently, but we don't really know. But it is a really exciting opportunity to learn more about these very rarely encountered fishes.
Yeah. Is there one thing that sticks out to you when you actually saw the fish in person, you know, for the first time, right, as somebody who's been geeked out about these? What was it that struck you about it?
I think the most striking thing about this particular type of anglerfish is that the lure on top of its head is called an esca. And just how big and ornamented it is. It's really striking. And just to be able to see, you know, all the little appendages, those little tentacles hanging off of it close up, and see kind of how that thing, you can imagine it glowing in the deep sea and attracting, you know, a squid or a fish towards the fish.
Yeah, that was really cool. Fascinating. Now, of course, if somebody does come across something that looks like, now, deep sea creatures obviously have a very unique look to them. I mean, scary, right? What should they do if they come across one?
I think the best thing you should do is go find a local lifeguard at the beach, notify them. They'll generally get in touch with me or somebody else in the county who will get in touch with me. You can also email us here at Scripps at scrippsnews@ucsd.edu, and they'll also get in touch with me or somebody else here at Scripps who studies whatever you found.
Well, Ben, very interesting stuff, and thank you so much for teaching us a little bit more about this football fish, because obviously it's very fascinating, very interesting looking, and I'm glad that it's very deep in the sea.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Thanks, Ben. We'll talk again.